morning students. Today we are going to learn a new topic, that is lines and angles. First of all, we are going to learn the basic terms that are related to this topic, that is lines and angles. So students, see, what is this? This is a point. Now what is a point? Point is a dot that has no length and no breadth. Actually, it is dimensionless. Now see, if I will extend this point in one direction infinitely, what does it will become? It will become a ray, and ray has one end point. This is a fixed point. Now if I will see the opposite side of this ray as well, now what it will become? It will become a line. So children, this is a line. We are going to learn more about lines in this chapter. Now we will define line. Line is a set of points that has only one dimension, and it has length as its dimension. Students, see, when I'll take a part of this line segment, when I have taken the part of this line will become line segment. This line segment has two end points. One is starting point and one is end point. Now children, we are going to learn angle. When two rays are joined together with the one common end point, it will become a angle. Now this common point is called vertex, and here an angle is formed. This is an angle. Now we have learned the meaning of the chapter, lines and angles. Now we have learnt about the lines as well as angles. So children, we are going to learn few real life examples of the terms that we have learnt. Point. Tip of a pen is a point. For ray, we have sun rays. See, sun is the fixed point and the rays are coming, that are the rays. Line. You have seen railway lines. There is no starting point and no end point of railway lines. So it is the example of line. Line segment. Edge of a book, edge of a scale, these all are line segments because they have fixed measurement. Angle. Pair of scissors, when opened, it forms an angle. Now we are going to learn more about the types of angles. There are different types of angles. First, we will take right angle. The angle which measures exactly 90 degree is called right angle. This is a symbol of 90 degree. The angle which measures less than 90 degree is called acute angle. You can see this angle is less than 90. This is 90 degree. This angle is less than 90 degree. It is called acute angle. Another is obtuse angle. If the angle is having the value more than 90 degree, this is called obtuse angle. You can see that this is more than 90 degree. Now next we will learn about straight angle. Next is, you can even say straight line angle also. When the angle is formed on a straight line, it measures 180 degree. Here at this point angle is formed and it is on a straight line, therefore it has 180 degree as its measure. The another we are going to learn is reflex angle. Reflex angle is actually more than 180 degree, and reflex angle is, see class, it is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. It lies actually between 180 degree and 360, like as 180 above. So let's say this is the angle formed. 180 is somehow here, and if I'll go to take the more of 180 degree, this angle is more than 180 but less than 360. 360 is actually the complete angle, 360. So if it is less than 360, it is called reflex angle. Now the next we will learn is complementary angles. Now, pair of angles are called complementary angles if they will sum up to 90 degree. So let's take few examples. Let us suppose that I'll take one angle as a 30 degree. If I have to make a pair of complementary angles, another angle should be 60 degree so that their sum is 90 degree. So 30 degree plus 60 degree is 90. Therefore, these two angles forms a pair of complementary angles. The another example we can take is like as one angle if is 70 degree, the another should be 20 so that they will sum up to 90 degree. You can check whether they are forming the 90 degree or not. Yes. So therefore, these are pair of complementary angles. The next we are going to learn is supplementary angles. If the pair of angles sum up to 180 degree, then the angles will become supplementary. Let us take few examples, like as if my one angle is 110, the another should be 70 degree so that they will sum up to 180 degree to become supplementary. So it is like this, 110 and another is 70. If I'll add these two angles, it will become 180. Yes, therefore they form the pair of supplementary angles. The another example I can take, let us suppose that I'll take one angle, let's say 90, the another should also be 90, so that they will form the pair of supplementary angles, that is 180. If I'll ask you the question that find the supplementary angle of 110, you can answer that 70. That means because they should sum up to 180 to become supplementary. So therefore, we should take those two angles whose sum will become 180 degree. Now it's a time for homework. Dear students, do the following questions and we will discuss the doubts in the next class. Thank you.